إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله، we praise Allah and we seek His assistance and we seek His forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah from the evil within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whoever Allah guides, there is none that can lead him astray. And whoever is led astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that no God has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is alone and has no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. O you who believe, fear Allah as you ought to be feared, and don't die except as Muslims. O humanity, fear your Lord who has created you from a single soul, and created from it its mate, and scattered from them to many men and women. And fear Allah for whom you demand your mutual rights, and don't cut off relations with the womb that bore you. Indeed, Allah is a raqib, a watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct, in order that He may accept from you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved the greatest achievement. Amma ba'du. Certainly the most truthful speech is the Book of Allah. And the finest guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of affairs are newly invented matters in this deen. And every newly invented matter in this deen is a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is a strain. And every strain is in the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Him to bless everyone who has attended this Jumu'ah and all of the Muslims. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enter us into Jannah and to save us from the hellfire. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us our fasting and to accept from us our night salah and to accept from us our good deeds in this month of Ramadan. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam reminds us, encouraging us to continue this fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this statement, alayhi salatu wa salam, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. From the hadith of Al-Bukhari and Muslim, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, whoever fasts Ramadan, desiring the reward from Allah, and doing it sincerely and solely for His sake, then all of his past sins will be forgiven. Here the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam is encouraging us to seek the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this fast, and to keep our intentions sincerely and solely for His sake while we're fasting this month of Ramadan. And if we do so, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would forgive us of all of our sins. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us of all of our sins. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, and another narration of this hadith also collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim, he says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, whoever stands in night salat in Ramadan, desiring by it the reward of Allah, and doing it sincerely and solely for His sake, then all of his past sins will be forgiven. This is an encouragement from the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam for us to keep up our night salat, and not to give up the Taraweeh but to continue it, desiring for it the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and doing it for His sake alone, so that He can forgive us of all of our past sins. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us of our past sins. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, he also has encouraged us when we're making this night salah to stay in the jama'ah with the imam, as this is the biggest reward. As the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the hadith collected by Imam Ahmad and the people of the sunnah, and this hadith is authentic, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّهُ مَنْ قَامَ مَعَ الْإِيمَانِ حَتَّى يَنْصَرِفَ كُتِبَ لَهُ قِيَامَ لَيْلًا. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, he says, indeed, whoever makes the salah, that referring to the night salah, with the imam until he is finished, then he will be rewarded as if he made salah all night long. Here the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam is encouraging us to go to the masajid and to make the salatu tarawih in the jama'at with the imam, so that we can get the reward of making the salah all night. And as for those who ask the question, what about doing some more night salat after the tarawih, Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, in this same hadith from Imam Ahmad radiallahu anhu, he had made salat in the last 10 days with the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. And he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, can I do some nawafil salat after this? After making the night salat with the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever makes the night salat with the imam until he is finished, then he will be rewarded as if he made salat for the whole night. So this is an encouragement for us to continue the salat of tarawih with the imam, so that we can get the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for His believers. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, he's encouraging us to continue this fast and to continue this salat for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in desiring His reward. And the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam, in these days, as tonight we're approaching the last 10 days of Ramadan, the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam even worked harder for his fast and worked harder for his night salat for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل العشر شد مئزره وأحيا ليله وأيقظ أهله. And this is collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. وعائشة رضي الله عنها, she said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he entered the last 10 days of Ramadan, when he entered the last 10 days of Ramadan, he would leave his wives alone. Or it could mean, as some of the ulama say, he would continue to work harder in his worship for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would spend all night being awake in worship of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And he would wake his family to make salat with him, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Tonight, inshaAllah ta'ala, will be beginning the last 10 days, and it's upon us to take the advice of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa sallam in his sunnah by waking up all night for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As this is from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when the question comes, as it has come, what about our job? If we're up all night worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we're going to be asleep all day when it's time to go to work. Tell your boss you want to take a vacation. And when he tells you, when he asks you, where are you going? Say, I'm going to worship my Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala in the masjid. Tell your boss you want a personal day. I want to get a closer personal relationship with my Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tell your boss that you want to take a sick day. I'm sick of working for this dunya and I want to work for the akhirah. This is from the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam. We can plan our vacation time, our personal days and our sick days on these last 10 days so that we can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the month of Ramadan. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَجْتَهِدُ فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مَا لَا يَجْتَهِدُ فِي غَيْرِهَا. And this is also collected by Al-Bukhari and Muslim. وَعَائِشَ رَضِيَ ta'ala anha, she said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will work harder in the last 10 days than he would in any of the other days. We're approaching these last 10 days, and this is a reminder for myself and the believers to increase our worship for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these last 10 days. Especially when the Laylatul Qadr is in these last 10 days, as the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam says in the authentic hadith collected by al-Bukhari and Muslim, تحروا ليلة القدر في الوتر من العشر الأواخر من رمضان. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this hadith of al-Bukhari and Muslim, he says, work hard to find the Laylatul Qadr in the odd days from the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan. Because this is the magnificent day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoke about in the Quran, where he says, Subhanah, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr, wa ma adaraka ma laylatul qadr, laylatul qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Indeed, we have rebuilt it on Laylatul Qadr. We have rebuilt the Quran on Laylatul Qadr. And what will make you realize what Laylatul Qadr is? Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. Than 1,000 months. Here the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this surah is showing us the magnificence of this Laylatul Qadr. More than 83 years. 1,000 months. And that worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day is not like on any other day. That you're fasting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake on Laylatul Qadr. That you're standing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that your good deeds for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your worship of Him is magnified on this Laylatul Qadr, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows in this surah the importance of Laylatul Qadr. And just as the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shows its importance with the hadith of al-Bukhari and Muslim, مَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. That whoever stands making salah to Allah and worshipping Him on Laylatul Qadr, desiring the reward from Allah and doing it sincerely and solely for His sake, all of his past sins will be forgiven. The Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam is encouraging us to stand on this night. And Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the mother of the believers, was very concerned about this night, as she said to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَرَأَيْتَ إِنْ عَلِمْتُ أَيَّ لَيْلَةٍ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ مَا أَقُولُ فِيهَا. فَقَالَ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُولِي أَلَّهُمَّ إِنَّكَ عَفُوٌ تُحِبُّ الْعَفْوَ فَعْفُ عَنِّي. And this is collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi and it's authentic. Where Aisha radiallahu anha, she asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you see, if I knew which night was Laylatul Qadr, what should I say on that night? And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, say, O Allah, you are afu, you are the pardoner, and you love to pardon, so pardon me. This is the dua of the believers on Laylatul Qadr. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني. This is an encouragement from the Messenger of Allah عليه الصلاة والسلام and a reminder for the believers to step up the pace for the last 10 days of Ramadan, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us of our past sins.